Hey guys, welcome. Welcome back to Vedantu's JEE channel. How are you guys? I especially want to welcome all my students who are JEE 2021 aspirants. That means people who are moving from 11th to 12th standards. Yes guys, this is specifically the day and the time when we meet to discuss the theory for JEE 2021. And today is the continuation of the chapter of current electricity, and the name of the topic that I'm going to teach today is Wheatstone Bridge. Yes guys, something, you know, it's not so unfamiliar for all of us, because Wheatstone Bridge is a terminology that we saw in the case of capacitance as well. Okay, so guys, we'll be taking this awesome session forward. I hope all of you are geared up, all of you are excited to solve a lot of questions, because the concept is very simple. It's all about problem solving today itself. Okay, so guys, let's go forward and let me start off with my introduction as always. Okay, for people who are new, let me introduce myself to them. Guys, this is me, your Suri sir. I am an alumnus of IIT Bombay, and on this channel, I am more popularly known as Mogambo. Why am I called that? Is because when you will crack this examination of JEE in this year, next year, or next to next year, as per your year of appearance, Mogambo khush hoga. Yes, guys, when you will crack this examination, Mogambo will be happy. Okay. Also, if you are new, probably you would want to know, when exactly should you be coming live on this channel to attend all the lectures? So guys, for people who are aspiring for JEE 2021, the timings are very crucial to remember. Every day at 9 PM, we discuss theory that is related to physics, chemistry, maths of JEE. And 3 days in a week, we meet to discuss MCQs. Which are those days? That's Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Okay. Also, this is your Harsh sir. He teaches you all chemistry. This is Arvind sir. He teaches you all mathematics. And yes, this is me. I try to teach you all physics. Okay, guys. So I hope the timetable is clear, simple enough to remember. Every day at 9 o'clock, definitely you have to be here to learn theory. And on Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday, you should be on the channel to learn the MCQs. Okay. Also, guys, if you are new on the channel, then definitely I would want you people to subscribe to the channel right now. Also, press the bell icon so that whenever your Mogambo comes live, your Suri sir comes live, you will get the notification about the starting of the lecture. Okay, guys. Also, you know that on Vedantu's platform, we have, apart from these YouTube sessions, we have an awesome platform where students around the year are engaged with all the master teachers, where they learn, you know, basics and concepts of different examinations like JEE, NEET, and not just for 11th and 12th, we have students starting from 6th standard till 12th standard. Okay, so if you are interested in coming on Vedantu's platform, there is an amazing platform waiting for you all, and let me just give you a brief idea about that as well. So guys, the platform, the subscription which is available for anybody to grab at this point of time is what we call as VPro or Vedantu Pro. Okay, for that, obviously, more detailed informations can be found on this link, which is available in the description box, also on the comment box. Okay, so when you are going to click over there, you will be taken to a page where you will have to select the standard that you are studying in or you are moving to. So 11th or 12th standard, assuming that. And along with that, you will have to select the examination that you are preparing for. So if you are a JEE aspirant, you will select JEE examination as your exam. If you are a NEET aspirant, you will select NEET as your examination. Also, let me tell you, what exactly should you expect out of the subscription? So you will get unlimited access to the live interactive sessions with your master teachers, unlimited access to assignments and the study material, and all the online test series and the performance analysis. Let me give you a brief idea of that. So you will have 40,000 plus hours of live teaching, 20 plus master teachers who are very experienced in the field will be teaching you all, a lot of testing and assignments, options to choose between Hindi or English as your, you know, medium of learning, also continuous review and the, you know, feedback given to you as per your area of improvements, and unlimited access to the micro and the crash courses of Vedantu. By the way, this is how the platform of Wave, that's what we call it. Okay, we call it Wave platform. This is how it looks like. This is Pulkit sir teaching. At the same time, students are live. They can chat with class teachers. They can chat with each other. There is a Q&A panel where you can ask your doubts as well. And this is where the concept explanation is happening. Okay, guys. So if you are interested in joining this awesome platform to learn from the master teachers, there are multiple subscriptions possible: monthly, quarterly, half yearly, or annually. Okay, definitely as you move towards a longer subscription, the per month charges will be different. Okay, so if you are interested in that, you can enroll by the following link. And if you enroll now, there is an additional 15% discount. All you have to do is go on this link, which is available in the description for you to just click. Okay, and when you are taken over there, don't forget to use this coupon code to avail additional 15% discount on any of the subscriptions which I have shown you on this slide. Okay, guys, I hope things are clear to all of you. Okay, guys, awesome. So do take the advantage and see you on Vinatu's platform as well. Cool. Now, guys, let's get back to the Wheatstone Bridge. The topic that we are going to talk about is Wheatstone Bridge today, and it's actually just an additional part, or you can say a subtopic of current electricity. So guys, a very, very, very short theory part today and a lot of problem solving waiting for us. So let's go forward. So I'm sure you already have started visualizing how exactly a Wheatstone Bridge looks like. This is a typical diagram of a Wheatstone Bridge, which has typically around 5 resistors. It could have more resistors as well. We'll show you in form of examples. So what you see here is a circuit which has a connectivity with a battery and some current which is starting from the battery. Okay, let's say that current is I. Now what happens in this particular circuit, guys? You see that there are resistances R1, R2, R3 and Rx. You can call it R4 as well. Okay, so what happens in case of a Wheatstone Bridge? If you have an arrangement with a possible condition that R1 by R3 is equal to R2 by Rx, or you can also say R1 by R2 is equal to R3 by Rx. The condition has been written over here. If this condition is satisfied, then what happens? The potential of point Q is equal to potential of point S. Means what? These two points that you see here, yes, these two points will have the same value of potential, because of which there will be no current which will flow in this particular branch. That means the value of IG will become zero. As of now, we are showing it as there is a galvanometer connected. Why would you place a galvanometer there? Just to see whether there is a current flowing in the circuit in that branch or not. So when you will see that the current in that branch is becoming zero, whenever that will happen in this particular type of circuit, you will find out that is only possible when the ratio of R1 and R2 is equal to R3 and Rx, or you can also call it R1 by R3 equal to R2 by Rx. Only this much is what I want you people to remember. Okay, the derivation is also not that important from J point of view. Please remember either this as the condition or R1 by R3 equal to R2 by Rx. You can call it R4 as well. Okay, guys. So just the rearrangement of this and you will see that the value of this branch, or rather the value of the current in this branch, will become zero. So all you will have to do in such cases is remove this branch, because there is no current flowing, no electricity being consumed. So you can say that R1 and R2 are in series and R3 and Rx are in series. So effectively, if I have to draw the circuit, this is how the equivalent circuit will become. Okay, I'm drawing only those 4 resistances, that is R1, this is R3, this is R2, and this is Rx. Okay, so same current I was going here, and it will come out of the circuit as well. So you can see R1 and R2 are in series, R3 and Rx are in series, and you'll be able to simplify the circuit after that. Okay, cool, awesome, awesome, guys. So let's see some examples to understand the concept even at a very fundamental level, along with the problem solving part. So guys, the first question that we have to solve here says that the potential difference between point A and B is what we have to find out. How much is that potential difference between A and B is going to be? So, without the knowledge of Wheatstone Bridge, obviously you will try to find out the value of the current which is flowing here. How much current is going in these two branches, say from point P, and say this point is Q. So point P and point Q will see current splitting over here. What you see here that the value of resistance above and the value of resistance below are given, so you can easily find out the value of the resistance and eventually the value of current also. But before I show you that that is going to happen, let's just for a moment check what is the value of the resistances that we were talking about. That means what? If I consider this resistance as R1, this as R2, this as R3, and this as R4. So let me check R1 by R3. Is it equal to R2 by R4? Is it equal to R3 by R2 by R4 or not? So you can see that this is 8 by 4, which comes out to be 2. And the other one is 6 by 3. That also comes out to be 2. That means definitely and definitely the value of potential of B is equal to potential of A. Which means what? The difference of potential between them is actually 0. That's going to be the answer. Definitely. Yeah. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to just show you that that is possible by this method. That's a shortcut. Okay. But if you want to take the real and the other approach which we knew before this, okay, this approach which we took right now is also genuine. It's also acceptable in your board examination. But if you want to just see or test whether our performance is right, or as in the approach is right or not, so let's just see how much is the resistance in the upper branch, guys. So 8 plus 6, this resistance is basically 14 ohms, and this is 4 plus 3, that is 7 ohms. That means we can say that in the upper branch the resistance is 2x, in the lower branch the resistance is just x. Yeah, because it is x, so the double resistance is in the upper branch. So guys, you know that the potential difference in the two branches is going to be 10 volts only. Why is it so? Because both of them are connected in parallel. So for that to happen, the current which will go here is going to be I by 3, and the current which will go here is going to be 2I by 3. Lesser be the resistance, more be the value of the potential. So if I consider that this point is P, then Vp minus Vb, if I look for, then Vp minus Vb, guys, comes out to be, the potential difference is going to be I by 3 into the resistance which was R1. That comes out to be I by 3 into 8, which is 8I by 3, right? Similarly, if I find out Vp minus Va, then it is going to be 2I by 3, and this resistance was R3. So that is 2I by 3 into 4, which is also 8I by 3, which means what, guys? From P to A and from P to B, the value of potential difference is same. That is only possible when you have potential of A same as that of B. Okay, so that's why the potential difference between A and B is going to be 0. Understood, guys? So this was the Kirchhoff's approach, but without that we can solve this answer or solve this question by understanding that it's a Wheatstone bridge condition satisfied here. Okay, cool. Okay, now this question says that the value of R in the circuit so that there is no current in the 50 ohm resistance. That means we have to remove this. So we have to basically look for the Wheatstone bridge condition, which is going to be 10 by R should be equal to 20 by 40. So this gets cancelled. I have R equal to 4 into 10 by 2, which comes out to be 20 ohms. Okay, simply if it is 1:2 ratio, it has to also be 1:2. So answer has to be 20 ohms. Okay, guys, cool. How about this one? This says that in the circuit shown in the figure, the current drawn from the battery is 4 amperes given to us. If 10 ohm resistor is replaced by 20 ohm, so this resistor which is here, if it is replaced by 20 ohms, then the current that is drawn from the circuit will be how much? So if this resistance is going to change the overall resistance of the circuit, then definitely there will be change in the current that is drawn from the battery. But for that, just check out the ratio, or you can say the Wheatstone bridge condition. What you see here, that R1 by R3 is 1 by 7, and R2 by R4 is 3 by 21, which is also 1 by 7, which simply means what? There is no current which is going to flow in this branch, which simply means whichever be the resistance that you connect there, it's not going to consume any energy, it's not going to draw any current. So that's why the current that will be drawn from the circuit will still remain the original value, and that is 4 amperes. Okay, so we can simply say that R1 by R3 is equal to R2 by R4. So no change in the value of the current drawn from the battery. It will still remain the same. That is 4 amperes only. Okay, now this one. So we have a typical Wheatstone network given to us, and the resistances are also mentioned 10, 5, 4 and 4. You can see that 10 by 4 and 5 by 4 definitely are not going to give us the same ratio. So question is asking us which of these options will make the Wheatstone bridge balanced. Okay, so guys, let's look at all the options to check. If I connect 10 ohm resistance in parallel with A, so if you connect a parallel resistance of 10 ohms here, then what will happen? 10 and 10 will become 5, and 5 by 4 and 5 by 4 will definitely be going to be the same ratio. So definitely answer A is correct. But let's check if there is any other possibility here. Okay, for that, let's go through the other options. Option B says 10 ohms should be connected in series with A. Obviously, that will make this resistance branch as 20, and 20 by 4 will be not as 5 by 4. So this is not the correct answer. How about this? 5 ohms should be connected in series with B. So this is B, and I'm going to connect one more 5 here. So 5 plus 5 will become 10. So 10 by 4 and 10 by 4 again gives you the correct answer here, right? But if we look at option D, it says 5 ohm should be connected in parallel. If you will connect 5 ohm in parallel here, 5 by 5 will become 2.5, which will obviously not be the correct answer again. So guys, very rarely this will happen. In fact, in JE, this will never happen. But here, if it is JE Advanced you consider, there are two options which are giving you the correct answer. Okay, so that is A and C being the correct answer. B and D are incorrect. Okay, guys. Cool. Moving on. So in this given figure, we have to find out the equivalent resistance between A and B. So you see that 3 by 6 is half and 4 by 8 is also half. So definitely this resistance is not going to affect anything. So effectively, I have the equivalent circuit diagram look like this, which is 3 and 4 connected in series, 6 and 8 connected in series. So 3 and 4 are 7. 6 and 8 are 14 ohms. So we have to find out RAB now, which comes out to be 14 into 7 upon 14 plus 7, that is 21. That comes out to be 14 by 3. Right, guys? So answer comes out to be option A. Okay? So you just have to remove the branch which is not drawing any current, and after that 3 and 4 ohms are in series, 6 and 8 ohms are also in series. Simplified and solved it. Okay, how about this one? It says that the effective resistance between point P and Q will be how much is what we have to find out. So again, guys, look at this. 2R by R is equal to 2R by R, which means what? This branch is useless in terms of the current not being drawn there. Similarly, R by 2R and R by 2R is also the same ratio. So this branch will also not draw any current. So I can say that these two are connected in series. These two are connected in series and these two are also connected in series. So equivalently, now I have three branches which are parallel to each other, such that this is 4R, this is 2R and this is 4R again. So if you look at 4R and 4R, they are in parallel. So further simplification makes it 2R and 2 small r. 4 capital R and 4 capital R, both of them are in parallel. So their equivalent is 2R and that is in parallel with small 2R. Okay. So guys, now the equivalent resistance RPQ will be equal to R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So 2 taken common, this is R plus R. One of the 2's get cancelled. We have 2 capital R small r divided by R plus R as our correct answer. Okay, which very easily we can find out as answer option A. Okay, guys, cool. Now this one, this says that in the circuit shown, it says that resistance P and R, they are not same, and the reading of galvanometer is same with switch S open or closed. That means what? This branch is not going to draw any current. Which means what, guys? पी एंड क्यू दीज आर इन सीरीज. सिमिलरली गैल्वेनोमीटर एंड आर दे आर इन सीरीज. राइट गाइस, सो वॉट कैन आई से द करंट विच इज गोइंग ओवर हेयर, से इट इज आई वन, सो डेफिनेटली दिस इज ऑल्सो आई वन, बट द करंट दैट इज गोइंग इन द लोअर ब्रांच इज आई टू एंड इफेक्टिवली joins to become I. So when we look at the options here, first option says IR is equal to IG. IR is equal to IG and that is equal to I2. So looks like answer option A is correct. Let's check other options. Is IP equal to IG? Not sure. It only will be when upper branch and lower branch, they have the same resistance. Similarly, IQ equal to IR is also a very particular condition. And IQ equal to IG. If IQ is not equal to IR, it will not be equal to IG as well. So answer is option A. Okay, guys. Cool. Now this one, this says that in the arrangement of the resistances shown in the figure, the potential difference between point B and D will be zero. Point B and D are at the same potential, so that they have zero potential difference. Only when the unknown resistance X is how much. Okay. So you see that in the top branch, A to B, this is 12 plus 4, that means it is 16 ohms. And here from A to D, the resistance comes out to be 4 ohms. Okay. Here, 1 and 1 are in parallel, so it is 0.5 ohms. Okay, guys. So we can say that 16 by 4 will be equal to X by 0.5, or you can say half. So X comes out to be 16 by 4 into half, which is nothing but 16 by 8 or simply 2 ohms. So the value of resistance that you will have to connect between B and C is 2 ohms. Okay, we got this already. Now this one, this says that the current drawn from 5 volt source will be how much. So how much current I is, which is starting from the battery, is what we have to find out. Now guys, this is a different but a very, again, a very common way of representing a Wheatstone bridge. Let me show you how is that going to happen. So let's say that this point is A and say this point is B and this point is C and this point is D. So if I say point A is here, point B is here, point C and similarly point D effectively. So just have a look at the branches that I'm drawing. Okay guys, so what you see here, all the resistances which are drawn, between A to C, you have a 5 ohm. So this is 5 ohm. Between A and D, it is 10 ohms. So this is 10. Between C and D, you have another 10. Between C and B, you have 10 ohms. And between D and B, you have 20. Okay, so guys, if you try to check the ratios, you will find out that 5 by 10 and 10 by 20 have the same ratio, which simply means what? This resistance effectively is not going to draw any current. We have to find out the net current that is drawn. So for that, we'll require the equivalent resistance, and our equivalent over here, let's solve it. For 5 plus 10, that is 15. Below, it is 10 plus 20, that is 30. So 15 into 30, that is R1, R2, upon 15 plus 30, that is 45. 5 will cancel this, 15 will cancel this 45 three times. So R equivalent comes out to be 10 ohms. So how much is the current that the battery is going to supply is V by R equivalent. V is 5 volts, this is 10. That means current drawn from the battery is 0.5 amperes. Okay, guys, that means the correct answer comes out to be option B. Okay. Okay, now this one. This says that an ammeter which is here, which is going to read the current which starts from the battery only. Okay, my mistake. The direction of the current drawn wrong. Okay, the current is going to move like this. So maybe the current which is starting from the battery is I, and that is what actually is to be found. The meter will read the value of the current as how much. So if you look at these guys, 5 and 5, 5 and 5 are making a Wheatstone bridge, which means what? Here, this resistance is going to be something which will not draw any current. So all in all, this is how your equivalent circuit diagram should look like. Okay, so this is what I'm getting here. So this is 5, this is 5, these two became 10, this is 5 and this is 5. Effectively, what I'm trying to tell you that this is 10, 10 and 10. So R equivalent is basically 10 by 3 ohms, right? So if you remove this branch, then 10, 10 and 10. So we have the R equivalent value, we have the voltage. So current comes out to be V by R equivalent. V is 10 volts, R equivalent is 10 by 3. So it comes out to be 3 amperes, right? Answer comes out to be option A. 3 amperes is our answer. Okay, guys, cool. Okay, here's your homework question, everyone. In the circuit shown here, we have to find out the current which will be flowing through 2 ohm resistance, which is here. Okay, so already 10 by 25 and 2 by 5 tells you that it's a Wheatstone bridge and this balance as well. So no current will be drawn here. So out of this 1.4 ampere, okay, it's 1.4 ampere, which has reached to this junction P and will go out of junction Q as well. Okay, you have to find out if current I1 will go on the upper branch, then how much is the value of that I1 is what you have to find out. I1 is the unknown current that you have to find out. Okay, so guys, do solve this question based upon the concepts of current electricity. Okay, it's a Wheatstone bridge which is balanced already. So solve this question and tell me your answer in the comment section. I will also see who is the fastest one and who is the correct one answering these questions. Okay, also guys, for all those JEE aspirants who want to meet more and more personalities, there is a new series which is coming up. Actually, a lot of new things are happening and even I'm not completely aware about it. It has been kept as a secret and we all will find it out very soon. It's going to be Master Talks with Achievers. You're going to meet a lot of personalities very soon. All I can say at this point of time is that stay tuned to this channel. We'll give you the updates. Okay. Also, for my students who are new on this platform and want to know how can I cover up the topics that I've missed, who were taught by Suri sir, Arvind sir, or my Harsh Maheshwari sir, how can you cover up is by going on the channel playlist. Okay, guys, when you will go to this channel playlist, this is the playlist that I want you people to look for. Jeet Low 2021 is the playlist that you will find out. There is a, you know, separate playlist for all the three subjects, physics, chemistry and maths is what you will find it out there. Okay, so do look for it, find out all the sessions which are there in a sorted manner. Just go through them so that you are in sync with what is happening in my classes here. Okay, cool guys. Also, for my students who are going to appear for JEE 2020, I know a lot of stress is going on. We are not even sure whether exam is happening or not. So a lot of tough time is being seen by you people. But how about a source of motivation, a source of inspiration? Well, guys, these are last year's students of Vedantu. They cracked JEE Advanced 2019 and they bagged their ranks under top 50 category. Okay, this is Rajdeep Singh who got All India rank 38, Chirag got All India rank 41, Sumit got All India rank 1 in PWD category. So guys, if these guys can do it from their home, even when there was no lockdown, no corona, then you guys, I know there is constraint, but there is an opportunity. Okay, don't look at this time as a threat or as a difficult phase. Rather, look at it as an opportunity to still continue your journey. Okay, and how can Vedantu be a help in that for all of you guys? So at Vedantu, we have the last batch of crash course which has begun, where we are giving away 90 plus live sessions by your very own master teachers, 20 plus tests as your test series, your own performance analysis will be shared with you, with, you know, your information about which topics you should be focusing more upon what are your strengths and weaknesses. And in the lectures, you will have rank booster quizzes and guys, a lot many more things. So if you are interested in the crash course, all you have to do is go on this link, which is available in the description box. Okay, also in the comment section, all you have to do is go on that, click and use this coupon code, that is SMCC, because course which is worth rupees almost 25,000 will become yours for just under 4,000 rupees. Okay, so do take the advantage, follow the link available in the comment section or in the description box. Okay, also people, if you are interested in joining our Telegram group where we share assignments, their solutions, study material and daily updates, so this Telegram group is free of cost for everyone to join. The link is again available in the description box of this video. Okay, so do follow that link and join the Telegram group. Okay, so guys, I hope you all enjoyed solving these questions about the Wheatstone Bridge. It's a very interesting topic and a very simple one. Okay, so if you did, then definitely give this video a thumbs up, press that like button. Okay, also share with your friends, tell them about the channel, about Suri sir, about the sessions which are going on here. And if you have not, then definitely subscribe to the channel right now, press the bell icon so that whenever Mogambo comes live, whenever Suri sir comes live, you will get the notification. Okay people, so I'll take your leave, I'll see you very soon. Till then, keep studying, keep enjoying physics, more importantly, as I always say, stay safe. Bye bye guys.